Oh my god, this movie is great. I have to have it on DVD. Holy shit, this is the first DVD I ever got. Hell yeah, I'm sure I'll get more DVDs in the future. I want Bad Boys 3 to happen. That would be so fucking awesome. Let's see if I can make it happen. Wow, I love Bad Boys 2 so much that I have to update the Wikipedia article about it and add history information. Even though I never actually get around to doing that. Lazy ass. Wow, I haven't thought of Bad Boys 2 in years or even watched it. I doubt I'm going back. Wow, I haven't watched Bad Boys 2 in years. I should watch it again now so I can review it. I'm sure it's still as good as it was back when I was a kid. Oh my god, there's a trailer for the third Bad Boys movie. Come on, I want that sequel to Bad Boys 2 when I was a kid. Now, I don't even care about the movie anymore. They should have made it a long time ago. Now it's far too late. Alright, the movie is finally up. Let's see how it goes. Hey guys, what's up? This is Blaze the Movie Fan. And I have a history with Bad Boys 2. That skit that shows that fucking history. Normally, the skits in my reviews serve no purpose other than trying to be funny. But the skit I showed you now fucking shows my history with the movie Bad Boys 2. I'm not going to explain the skit. I trust that most of you watching the video are smart enough to figure it out on your own just by looking at the fucking skit. But yeah, I think it's far too late to make a third Bad Boys movie. They should have done that back when I actually fucking cared about the franchise. Anyway, today I will be reviewing Bad Boys for Life. I hate to say this, but I didn't like this movie at all. Which is a shame, because I did watch Bad Boys 2 back in 2017. And that movie holds up extremely well. I haven't watched Bad Boys 2 since then, but I remember how fucking funny the movie was. But this one, well, I will be talking about the humor later. First, I'm going to talk about the characters, starting with Michael Lowry, played by Will Smith. Now, Mike is a complete fucking asshole. He wants to keep rolling with his friend, Marcus. He can't let go of the past and wants to keep being a badass cop. Yeah, it's as fucking pathetic as it sounds. And he is for some reason called a bulletproof man? What the fuck? When the hell was that established that he can't be killed? I don't remember that happening in Bad Boys 2. It must be something that happened off screen between the events of Bad Boys 2 and Bad Boys 3. I hate when movies throw something like that to our faces without properly fucking establishing it. Yeah, fuck Mike. And this movie is also about him retiring or needing to retire. And I'll be honest, I'm not a fan of movies that are about someone's retirement at all. I find these movies extremely fucking boring because what exactly is interesting about seeing someone retiring? That doesn't make for an interesting movie at all, in my opinion. Now I'm going to talk about his friend, Marcus Miles Burnett, played by Martin Lawrence. The poor guy just wants to fucking retire to take care of his family. But Michael doesn't respect that at all and keeps harassing him until he gives in. Marcus thankfully fucking doesn't. But there is no reason for Mike to keep harassing him for that. What a dick. The next character that I want to talk about is Ronald Howard, played by Joe Pantolina. Oh my god, I feel so sorry for this Polish captain. I really do. He gives legitimate reasons as to why Mike shouldn't try to solve the case on how somebody fucking shot him. Oh, by the way, Mike surviving a bullet somehow is a downright non-issue to me. This is a movie after all that I don't expect it to be 100% realistic. Anyway, like I was saying, Conrad has legitimate reasons as to why Mike is not allowed to try to solve the case. But he never fucking listens and goes through wanting revenge regardless of that. You know what? I'm gonna come right on and say it. Mike is a motherfucking cunt. Without question. Alright, now that I'm done talking about the characters, there are other issues with the movie that I need to address. The main issue that I have with the movie, aside from the characters, is that it bored the hell out of me. I left once during this movie. Once. And that was at the beginning of the movie. But for the rest of it, I was bored out of my mind. I was desperately wanting the movie to just fucking end so I can review it. And I don't at all feel that way about movies that are bad in an interesting way, such as Cat in the Hat, The Island of Tinkmas movies, and Son of the Mask. I'm interested in seeing how worse those movies can get, but I don't feel that way about this movie. The fact that it's fucking boring is the main issue that I hear with it. There is one positive thing I can say about it though. The action sequences in the movie are fucking awesome. But I've said it before and I'll say it again. Good action sequences do not make for a good movie. If the movie fails at the most important aspects, which this movie does, good action means nothing in the long run. Another positive thing I can say about this movie is that it's inspiring me to watch Bad Boys 2 again, which is a much fucking better movie. I doubt I will ever hold it in as high regards as I did back during my teenage years. But tell you what, man, it's still a whole lot fucking better than this mess. And for that, I'm of course gonna give it a rating 2 middle fingers. Wow, I waited 17 fucking years for this garbage? So disappointing. Anyway, people, here is the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.